beloved in Christ. At this Christmastide, let it be our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even into Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purpose of God. From the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought to us by this holy child. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all God's people, for unity within the church he came to build, and especially in this community and on this campus. Because this would rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor and helpless, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick, and them that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus or love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which cannot be numbered, whose hope is in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are one forevermore. These prayers and praise us, lead us humbly to offer up to the throne of heaven in the words in which Christ himself hath taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. God tells sinful Adam that he has lost the life of paradise and that his seed will bruise the serpent's head. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God moving about in the orchard at the breezy time of the day. And they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the orchard. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" The man replied, "I heard you moving about in the orchard, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And the Lord God said, "Who told you that you were naked? Did you eat from the tree which I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." So the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" And the woman replied, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all the cattle and all the living creatures of the field. On your belly you will crawl, and dust you shall eat for all the days of your life. And I will put hostility between you and the woman, in between your offspring and her offspring. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." But to Adam he said, "Because you obeyed your wife and ate from the tree which I commanded you, you must not eat from it. The ground is cursed because of you. In painful toil you will eat of it all the days of your life. It will produce thorns and thistles for you, but you will eat the grain of the field. By the sweat of your brow you will eat food until you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken. For you are dust, and to dust you will return. Thanks be to God."
So God promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, I solemnly swear by my own name, decrees the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will greatly multiply your descendants so that they will be as countless as the stars in the sky or the grains of sand on the seashore. Your descendants will take possession of the strongholds of their enemies. Because you have obeyed me, all the nations of the earth will pronounce blessings on one another using the name of your descendants. Thanks be to God.
The prophet foretells the coming of the Savior. The people walking in darkness see a bright light. Light shines on those who live in a land of deep darkness. For a child has been born to us, a son has been given to us. He shoulders responsibility and is called Wonderful Advisor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His dominion will be vast, and he will be bringing immeasurable prosperity. He will rule on David's throne and over David's kingdom, establishing it and strengthening it, by promoting justice and fairness from this time forward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of heaven's armies will accomplish this. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The peace that Christ will bring is forsworn. A shoot will grow out of Jesse's rootstock. A bud will sprout from his roots. The Lord's Spirit will rest on him, a spirit that gives extraordinary wisdom, a spirit that provides the ability to execute plans, a spirit that produces absolute loyalty to the Lord. He will take delight in obeying the Lord. He will treat the poor fairly and make right decisions for the downtrodden of the earth. A wolf will reside with a lamb, and a leopard will lie down with a young goat. An ox and a young lion will graze together as a small child leads them along. A cow and a bear will graze together. Their young will lie down together. A lion, like an ox, will eat straw. A baby will play over the hole of a snake. Over the nest of a serpent, an infant will put his hand. They will no longer injure or destroy on my entire royal mountain, for there will be universal submission to the Lord's sovereignty, just as the waters completely cover the sea. Thanks be to God.
The angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the 6 months of Elizabeth's pregnancy, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, a descendant of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled by his words and began to wonder about the meaning of this greeting. So the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Listen, you will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will never end." Mary said, "How can this be, since I have not been intimate with a man?" The angel replied, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, and therefore the child to be born will be called Holy. He will be called Son of God." So Mary said, "Yes, I am the servant of the Lord. Let this happen according to your word." Then the angel departed. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. St. Luke tells of the birth of Jesus. Now in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus to register all the empire for taxes. Everyone went to his own town to be registered. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family line of David. He went to be registered with Mary, who was promised in marriage to him and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
The shepherds go to the manger. Now there were shepherds nearby living out in the field, keeping guard over their flock at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were absolutely terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. Listen carefully, for I proclaim to you good news that brings great joy to all the people. Today your Savior is born in the city of David. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a vast heavenly army appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among people with whom he is pleased. When the angel left them and went back to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, that the Lord has made known to us. So they hurried off and located Mary and Joseph and found the baby lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
The wise men are led by the star to Jesus. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, in the time of King Herod, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem saying, "Where is the one who was born King of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When Herod heard this, he was alarmed, and all Jerusalem with him. After assembling all the chief priests and experts in the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they said, "for it is written this way by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are in no way least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod privately announced and summoned the wise men and determined from them when the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and look carefully for this child. When you find him, inform me so that I can go and worship him as well." After listening to the king, they left, and once again, the star they saw when it rose led them until it stopped above the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they shouted joyfully. As they came into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother, they bowed down and worshiped him. They opened their treasure boxes and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. After being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they went back by another route to their own country. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
St. John unfolds the mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was fully God. The Word was with God in the beginning, and all things were created by him, and apart from him, not one thing was created that has been created. In him was life, and the life was the light of humankind. And the light shines on in the darkness, but the darkness has not mastered it. A man came sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify about the light so that everyone might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify about the light. The true light who gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was created by him, but the world did not recognize him. He came to what was his own, but his own people did not receive him. But to all who received him, those who believe in his name, he has given the right to become God's children. Now the Word became flesh and took up residence among us. And we saw his glory, the glory of the one and only, full of grace and truth, who came from the Father. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Please remain standing. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, you have pierced the darkness with the shining brightness of the true light. Grant that we who have known the mystery of the light on earth may also enjoy him perfectly in heaven. Amen. May God, who by God's incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, grant you the fullness of inward peace and goodwill, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.